got one. I mean, I'm just so blessed. I'm happy today, not because the weather is warm, but because I'm above ground, breathing, and the Lord is ahead of my life. I was at the doctor's office all day today, and they had some bad news and they had some good news. But whose report will you believe? So I'm standing here in the need of prayer. All those that know the word of prayer, pray for me. Pray for me. God is good. And all the time, God is good. The song I'm going to play today is Praise is What I Do. Anybody know anything about praising the Lord? You get in your house sometime and you find yourself and you get to praise. I like to run around the house in my underwear. You know why I do that? Because David did that. And God, I told him, I said, Lord, I ain't hiding nothing. You can see I need faith. I give it all to the Lord. Lord, watch me and fix me. Make me be what you would have me to be. Because when I wanted to be what I wanted to be, I messed it up. But God is in control.
Thank you. Ghost. Give God some glory right there. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Right there, give God some glory. You want to tell him that praise is what you do? Come on, come on, come on, let it on this place. Come on, that's what we do. We praise him. Glory to God. Thank you. Yes, 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 yes. Glory to God.
Just to be
Niagara Falls. Amen. And he don't have to send an evangelist, a preacher. We gonna do it for ourselves in our own city. Come on up and hear somebody. We keep reaching out when we have it right here in the city. Glory to God. I don't need nobody to preach me happy. I'm already happy. Come on up and hear somebody. My God, my God. I need somebody to get me in the presence of God. I need to really have an experience with the Holy Ghost. Come on, somebody. I'm tired of a good word. I want to feel Jesus. Come on, somebody. I want the power of the highest to come upon me. And I want to shout me and change my life. Glory to God. I don't need just a good word. I need Jesus. Thank you. Amen. I need Jesus. I want you to look at your neighbor and tell them, order in the court. Yeah, order in the court. Yeah. We have a system that's set up that any time that you will go into a courtroom, it is order that has to be the thing that the judge demands. And any time that it gets crazy in the courtroom, he hit his gavel and begin to tell you order. Yeah. Look at your neighbor and say, order in the courtroom. Yeah, order in the courtroom. We have come into the house of God and forgot that it is order in the courtroom. Come on, somebody. And we have got to get back to, just like we respect the judge, we got to respect the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We got to, the Jews system has their rules, they have their laws, they have their commands. And anytime you get out of order, they're going to let you know that you're out of order. And the church now has gotten out of order. Come on, somebody. But we need a touch from the Holy Ghost to put the church back in order. Look at some neighbors and say, oh, I hear the courtroom. Yeah. You got to have order. Yeah, sometimes you come and somebody beside you want to say something to you. You got to know sometimes that it's not time to talk right now. Yeah. See, because if you go into the natural system, you know that if you go in there, they will start talking and the bell will tell you, everybody be quiet. He will stand up and the bell represents the ushers. The ushers got to be bold now and in love with you. But remember years ago, we used to have the old mother ushers that if you were chewing gum, they would put a paper towel in their hand. Oh, y'all don't get what I'm saying. And they would walk around the church and they would walk over to you and they would put the hanky out telling you, spit your gum in here. Come on up and get somebody. Look at somebody and say, holiness is right. If don't nobody ever live holy, holiness is still right. We need all of here in the courtroom. Yeah, it's time to get back in order. I don't care what your title is. I don't care if they call you an apostle, a pastor, a preacher, a bishop, but you need order in the courtroom. We need to get bold preachers back in the pulpits that's going to preach the uncut gospel of Jesus Christ in love and without fear. With our favor, don't care who it hit. If it hit you, my God, just put your shoes on and wear them on the domain. If you, my God, can get mad at me when I'm telling you what the Bible says, get mad, but get yourself right in your faith time. Somebody say, get mad, but get right. Yeah. Look at your neighbor and say, order in the courtroom. We got to get order back in the house of God. We in a day and time where everybody knowing what they want to do. And we got to get order again in the courtroom. Listen, let's go to Psalms 100 and verse number 4. I want everybody to stand for the first scripture. And then you can sit down the rest of the day if you choose. The next time you stand up is going to be because Jesus made you stand, not because I asked you. Somebody say amen. Amen. Listen at this. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his court with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his holy name. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, open up the eyes of our understanding that we might be enlightened. Let the words of my mouth, meditation of my heart, be accepted in thy sight. For this we praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. You can be seated right now. Well, let's look at this here. When we're talking about the gates, enter in to his gates. Well, what you must understand is the gates of the temple are called gates of righteousness. The gates of the temple are called gates of righteousness. You cannot get into the gate of heaven unless you're righteous. Come on, somebody. You can get into these gates all day long. And it's one thing to come to these gates, but it's another thing to get from this gate to that gate. And so God says, in the temple they understood, because when the city was built back up after they was going down, they had to build the city back up. They made it a gate of righteousness because they went through some stuff. Look at somebody say, we've been through some stuff. And anytime you've been through some stuff, you understand that what you got, you didn't steal. And it's so precious that you learned one thing. If I do anything, I'm going to honor God. If you ever been through anything for real, and I'm talking about some real stuff. I'm talking about some stuff that makes you almost lose your mind. Some stuff that make people say that you're going to die, but you live anyway. Stuff that comes up on your body, and you know if the Lord don't show up, ain't nobody can do nothing for you. I'm talking about some real stuff. Look at somebody say the gates of holiness. These is the gates that I want to talk about today. When we're talking about coming to the courts, we're talking about coming to praise first. Well, the problem with most people, they think that praise is just praise and having fun. But we don't understand. Your praise is just a reflection of the righteousness in which you should live in. God has called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. And oh, what a marvelous light it is. Anytime that you want to understand the principles of the kingdom of God, it's only because God has to take you from one glory to another glory. Anytime you need to walk with God and you don't understand that if it had not been for the Lord who was on my side, I would have been swallowed up long ago. But in my God, in him I live, I move, and I have my being. Anytime a principality and a power comes against me, there's something on the inside of me that rises up and give God praise. I'm talking about a holy praise. I'm not talking about just saying something with your mouth. I'm talking about knowing God for real, baby. Look at somebody say, holy, holy, holy. I'm trying to slow down here. I'm trying to tell you that these gates are called gates of righteousness because they are entered into a place where, my God, only God can take you to this place. I'm going to get to a place that I never been before, only by the Holy Ghost. Look at someone say, the Holy Ghost. Let me just slow down. Let me slow down, because I want you to hear this. Because the temple of Jerusalem, hence, it's the church of Christ. It's the house of worship. It's the place in which we come in to meet God. We just don't come to have a conversation. When people talk to you in church, you need to start telling them, shh, I might miss something. Not today, devil. Look at somebody and say, not today, devil. I ain't talking to you today. I know you want to talk, but not today. We'll talk after church. But right now, my ears is trying to hear what the Spirit is saying to me. I don't want to hear what he said to you. I want to hear what he says to me. Come on. Somebody said, I'm tired of blaming you when it's me. Come on up and hear somebody. Say, I'm tired of blaming you when I'm the trying to figure out who wrote these songs. Some scholars say David did, and some dispute it. You know how it goes. But at the end of the day, it's written. Come on, somebody. Amen. And because it's written for us. Huh? Watch this. Open to me the gates of what? The gates of what? The gates of what? Open to me the gates of righteousness. He understood that he cannot be righteous in himself. He understood it. So he's telling God, open unto me the gates of righteousness, and I will what? Go into them, and I will praise the Lord. Yeah, if you open the gate, I'm going to walk in the gate, and I'm going to give you some praise. But it's the gate of oh, y'all, yes, yes, yes. Y'all with me, y'all with me. TP, are you with me? I had a Kirk Franklin moment. See, it's the gate of righteousness. The reason why it's called the gate of righteousness is because everybody can enter into this gate. Oh, y'all with me. Just because you see people praising God don't mean they're praising it from the gates of righteousness. Oh yeah, come on somebody. Yeah, just because you're jumping and popping don't mean you're praising them from the gates of righteousness. It's a difference when you come into the presence of God. We'll get there in a minute. Next scripture, next scripture. Watch this. This gate of the Lord. Oh, come on. This gate of the Lord into which the righteous shall enter. Not anybody. You can't have an ark and get to this gate. Come on, somebody. You can't hold on to stuff and get here. I can't stand here. I can't stand her. I'm committing adultery. I'm fornicating. You can't get into this gate, baby. Look at somebody say, repent. Look at somebody say, repent. You cannot get to the gate of righteousness in the flesh. No flesh should glory in my sight. Watch this. Come on. I will praise thee, for thou hast heard me, and I become my salvation. Look at somebody say, he's my deliverance. Yeah. Salvation means deliverer. Huh? Deliverance. So, yeah, when you really get to God, you get free. Come on, somebody. I said, when you really get to God, you get free. As long as you bow, you ain't made it to Jesus yet. I'm not telling you not, I ain't telling you to quit coming. I'm just telling you, you ain't made it yet, God. And somebody say, I'm so sorry. You got to keep on coming. Don't be like the turtle. I told y'all last week, the turtle won the race, not the rabbit. Come on, come on. Y'all thought the rabbit won, didn't he? Because he started off fast running. But when the rabbit got by the end to the finish line, he was too tired to cross over. And I told him last week about the turtle. Glory to God. Say, I'm just a turtle, baby. I might not be like you right now, but just wait a minute. I know you seem to be holier than me right now, but look at somebody say, I'm on my way. I'm taking one step at a time. I don't care where you are, but I'm coming, baby. Just know, before you count me out, you better count me in, because I'm on my way. Look at your neighbor and say, don't count me out. He's my deliverance. God is your deliverance. This is why you can't afford to allow anybody to stop you from praising God. Yeah. I just want to talk to you about courts for a minute. In the original Greek, It means to sing. Yeah, when you get a real praise, you gotta sing sometimes. You know what I mean? You ever get up with a song that's in your heart? You know, you wake up troubled in my ways. You gotta cry sometimes. You just feel so much trouble. I gotta pray sometimes. I lay awake at night. But that's alright. Cause I'm
shut it down.
Oh, y'all don't hear me. That this revival is over. Now, when R.W. Sherman heard that, he said, well, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord. Walk to the pulpit and start preaching. They called the police, put him in handcuffs, and took him to jail. Come on, somebody. They had him in jail, and they said, he said, no, Mr., they didn't have that much money at the time, so they came with all their nickels. They had a whole bunch of nickels, and they paid his bail. The next day, he was right back in the same place, doing the same thing, preaching the gospel, and here come the police again. This time, they put him in handcuffs. He said, when they threw him in the back of the wagon, he said, I was like, my Lord. But he said, when he seen the purge worship leader get through it, then he felt a little better. He said, I come to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ, and ain't nothing going to stop me from preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. I'm talking about the gates of heaven. When you really believe what you say you believe, you will die for what you believe. Even if they got to put you in jail, you're going to keep on preaching. They arrested him the third night. The third night, he entered into the court. He went from the gate to the courts of God. He said, all of a sudden, he said, the news media and everybody got wind of it. Come, y'all hear me. Look at God, said it's a setup. Anytime you're going through something, y'all, God is just setting you up to bless you. Come on, somebody. My God, it might look bad, but God is making it work together for your good. And let me tell you something. He said, when he got into the courtroom, look at somebody say the courtroom. When he got into the courtroom, after they were bringing him out, he said, by the time he got close to the courtroom, all he could hear was, the whole courtroom was full of saved folks speaking in tongues. Y'all hear what I'm saying? Y'all don't hear what I'm saying? Now, all the people that was in the area came into the courtroom and got and started praying. And the judge was sitting on the bench. And Sherman came out and he said, what's wrong? What's wrong? What's wrong? And Sherman looked at him and said, y'all got me here. He said, case dismissed. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying? Let me somebody say, oh God, do it! He said that night, thousands of people came. My God, more people than he could ever put in a tent came. Because God was setting him up. Because he wouldn't quit. Because he knew that if he kept on trusting God, that after time was going to be all right. I'm trying to close this thing down. It is here when all of us find out what we really are made of. It's easy to quote scripture, but it's something else when you got to live the scripture you quote there. Everybody look at a pastor and they say, you know what? I want to be a pastor. Do you really? Do you really want to be a pastor? You don't know what it comes with, baby. If I can take this room off and all this stuff off and sit in the audience, baby, I will sit with you and let the pastoring go where it got to go. You hear what I'm saying? But people don't understand the price of your anointing and your fragrance. In the courtroom, in the presence of God, this is why it says the court is talking about his presence. It's talking about the Shekinah glory. It's talking about that glory that destroys your, that anointing. When it talks about the anointing that destroys your, it's talking about the pure presence of God that hits your heart. And anytime the real pure presence of God hits your heart, it'll destroy everything that God's about. Oh, y'all don't hear me. Y'all don't hear me. I said the real presence of God will destroy every yoke in your life. This is why the devil don't want you to worship. This is why the devil don't want us to live right, because if we don't live right, we can't be right. We have a form of godliness, but we don't got no power. like this. You just laying there dead, but ain't no breath in you. Did you hear what I said? This is why you can't talk about another and come shout. This is why we got to be one in the church, one in the spirit. This is why the body of Christ, we're looking for a release from God. I'm tired of church as usual. I don't know about you. Come on, somebody. I said, I'm not happy until angels pop up. I'm not happy until Brother Joey jump off the keyboard and the keyboard keep on playing. Oh, y'all don't hear what I'm saying. I'm talking about the supernatural move of God. This is why people don't believe, because we ain't showing them nothing. Oh, y'all don't give me. I said, oh, in the court. Until the judges that sits on the benches, which is the pastors, get it together, ain't nothing going down like it should. We got the look. We got the robes. We got the chains. I'm so sick of all that stuff. We got our suits. We got our ties. Got our nice shoes. But we ain't got no power. With Israel, the Bible said they looked it like they were pregnant. It said that when it was time for them to break forth, they muffled wind. Nothing but wind. What nothing on nothing. And that's the way the church is today. We talking, but we ain't bringing forth. And God wants us to bring forth. We're pregnant with Jesus. Let's bring Jesus forth. When I come to church, I don't come to see you. I come to hear from God. Me and my mother talking about that last week. I told my wife, I said, look, when I come to church, I come to hear a word from the Lord. I may thank God for marriage and all that other stuff, but look, I want to hear from God. What is you saying to me? Don't, you know, some of us, we hear the word and we start throwing it across the church. Or somebody you know that's going through something, amen! Throwing it over there across the church with your devil out there, beat that demon in the name of Jesus. Because you know somebody in something and you heard it, amen! What need? And the priest, if he didn't discern it, he don't even realize that ain't a praise, that's a mess. It's time for us to get back and fast and pray so we can get our discernment back together and quit judging each other, calling it discernment. The Bible says we got to know each other by the Spirit. How am I know you by the trial? Oh, try the Spirit. I try the Spirit. How are you going to try my spirit if your spirit ain't right?
Happen.
Oh, come on, somebody. Holy hands mean clean. That means you ain't got nothing. You ain't got nothing between you and God but love. And you know what? You know I thank God, and I'm not boasting. I don't hate nobody. I don't dislike nobody. Anybody that don't like me, crazy. Anybody that don't like you is crazy. Because you just give a person power between you and God. How you gonna give somebody power over your life with God? That's why I don't let nothing linger. If somebody get me mad, I'm getting it out of the blood quick. I don't care if they're right and I'm wrong and they're right. Let's get this out of that blood. I need to pray for my family. I got crazy kids out there. I got to keep running the blood. This place here, I'm finished. This place here is the place that when Peter was in prison, the saints began to pray and offer praise. And the Bible said that the prison shook. Hey, the prison doors start dancing. Peter sitting up in there wasn't even worried. And they opened up and the angel took him out of the prison. Now watch this. He gets to the saints that was praying for him and they think a spirit at the door. They said, look, it looked like Peter, but I need a spirit. Righteousness. Righteousness exalts a nation. Do you hear this? Righteousness will exalt a whole nation. But sin is a reproach to any people. God is trying to tell the people of God the only reason why the world is sick because the church is sick. Order in the courtroom. I said order in the courtroom of God. It's time for us to get fear back in our heart towards the Lord. It's time for us to fall back in love with Jesus. It's time for us to tell God, you are the author and the finisher of my favor. You are my all in all. And I'm going to get myself together. I'm going to make an excuse for my flesh. And I'm going to live this life like I'm supposed to. You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We done walked away from holiness. We didn't walk away from God. We didn't create our own righteousness. You talk to saints today that want to be saints, they serve by they done lost their mind. You talk to people today, the word don't mean nothing that it says. Oh, I don't believe that the Lord going to throw you in hell for that. People call me. I'm going to tell you. People call me. And say, Pastor, why in the Bible do it say this or do it say that? And I'm so glad I get to explain it. We get to pull from the text now. And I said, you got time? He said, yeah. I said, let's go. Let me tell you what it is about. And I'm finished. The Lord let me know that it's about what you believe. We have stopped believing. Did you hear what I said? We have stopped believing. Anything that you believe, you do. Oh, come on, somebody. I said, anything that you believe, you do. But when you stop believing, you stop making excuses for what you used to do. Now you make an excuse and say, it ain't that bad. And y'all remember when we first got saved, you couldn't even talk to nobody without your heart getting swollen. Because you were so sensitive and pure. That's why God said you got to have a childlike spirit. Not childish, but childlike. Come on, somebody. There's a difference between childish and childlike. The problem with the church is they childish and thought it's right that they childlike. But look at your name and say, the devil is alive. It's time to grow up and meet men and women of the Most High God. Leave your family. Leave your community. Leave your kids. Leave your people around you. To Jesus, not to you, but to the Word of God. Tell them what Jesus said, even if they don't believe it. Some people don't believe it. They decided that Jesus is not real because of all these conspiracy theories and all this stuff on the internet. And you know, Jesus is black. Jesus is not black. Jesus is white. Well, Jesus, Jesus is a woman. Jesus is a woman. Jesus is a woman. Jesus, this is this all stuff you got going on. And the Bible says that the fool has said in his heart that there is no God. Show me a man that can place the sun in the sky and make it stay there. Show me a man that can put the moon in the sky and it stay there. Show me a man that can stretch stars all across the heavens and my God, I'll believe you. But until you tell me what man did, I'm going to believe in my God. God, my God. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was God. And the Word was with God. All things were made by him. And without him, nothing was made that was made. In him was the life of man. In him was made life. My God.
When he told her, now how can you touch it
or eat it, it'd be more like who told you not to do it. Look at somebody say, order in the court. See, this is the gospel of Jesus Christ. This is the kind of gospel that make people mad and then get them free. Oh, come on, somebody. I come from a church where preachers, even when they, you know, some things that they taught us weren't exactly biblically astute, but they meant well, and they preached holiness, and they believed what they believed, and it got us free for real. Come on up and hear somebody. Now, I know we shouldn't have been outside in the wintertime, I mean, in the summertime, you know, with whole suits on, hot as hell. And we talk about, Mother Hattie, look at them. They looking at me. Yeah, they looking at you. They said, that nigga real hot. They see no anointing. I'm burning up. But holiness don't change. Remember, last Sunday, Jesus the same yesterday, today, and forever. That's talking about his character, his holiness, and his righteousness. Because if you know the scripture, Jesus came in many forms. Come on, somebody. God came in many forms, but yet holiness wasn't different. He didn't come as an angel or come as a man or come as something else and say something different from the world. Because his character never changes. What's wrong today is going to be wrong to Jesus come. I love y'all, but order in God's courtroom. The church has got to get back on their face before God. We have got to start praying again and asking God to come in our hearts and change us. Something has happened to the church. I'm fighting for the church. I'm fighting with everything that I've got for the body of Christ. We got to get back to the word. We got to get back to what God said. Everybody standing. Order in God's courtroom. Order in the court. We're getting ready to dismiss. But before I dismiss, you know what's standing between you and God. You know whether you done everything you're supposed to be doing. And sometimes we lose that grip. Sometimes we lose that love and that zeal that we used to have. And it's all right. This is why we have these kind of services. For God can place back in your heart that holiness, that encouragement. I can hear the Lord say, Sister Connie, the best is yet to come. It might not feel like it. It might not look like it. But God says, I see you. And I hear your cry. Sometimes you feel like you're losing your mind. Sometimes you feel like you don't even want to go no more. Because of all the stuff you've been through. But I'm telling you right now. In the name of Jesus. That the best is yet to come. Break it off right now. Encourage her right now. In the name of Jesus. Loose her right now. Loose her right now. Loose her right now. Encourage her, Lord. In Jesus' name. Oh, Mama, shake care of us. Oh, that's it, that's it. God is mindful of you. He ain't forgot you. He ain't forgot you. He ain't forgot you. He see your pain. Shake up, Mama, Mama, oh, shake up. Mama Hattie, come here. Come here, Mother Hattie. I need you to go lay hands on her stomach and pray for her. Go lay hands on her stomach and pray for her. My God, my God. My God, my God. I said the best is yet to come. God knows your heart. He knows the battle that you've been feeling. He knows the struggle. Even when you're smiling and inside screaming, God said, I hear your scream. Some of us smiling for people, but on the inside we tore up. People don't see that. Because all they see is me smiling. It's here, Lord. This is what I'm trying to get back to. I lost some stuff and I can't seem to get it back. Jesus is here. Come on and reach up to him. Reach up to him. Come on, reach up to him. Get what you need from him right now. I don't have to lay hands on you. It's here. I said it's here. I said it's here. Jesus is here. Jesus is here. Jesus is here. Jesus is here. You ain't gonna never be the same again. Everybody that got anything, let it go. You can't hold it, it's too heavy. It'll destroy you. Just lift your hands, keep them up. Keep talking to him. Keep talking to him. Keep talking to him. I'm reaching to you, Jesus. I'm trying to get myself together. Listen, the best is yet to come. I can hear the Lord say, the best is yet to come. I can see your mind. Sometimes it's just going. Sometimes it's going so fast you can't seem to catch up with it. Hey, Sister Cook, go lay hands on her head for me. Go lay hands on Lizzie's head for me. Just touch her head. Just touch right now. We quiet your mind down right now. We quiet your mind down right now. In the name of Jesus, say to the Lord with you. Lose your hope right now. Lose your hope right now. In the name of Jesus, the Spirit of the living God be upon you right now. I love Spirit. Let us not be deceived anymore. let us love you with our whole hearts, with our minds and our souls, oh God. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Come on and clap your hands for Jesus. Listen. I told them last night, and sometimes preachers have come to a city and preach to us, and they are asked for $500 and all that, and we give it to them. But we got great men and women of God right here in Niagara Falls. And sometimes we don't even want to give them a $20 bill. Sowing good ground. Somewhere you know when you sow, it's coming back to you. I'm starting off again tonight with $50. Now, if God tells you to get 50, get 50. If he tells you to get 25, get 25. But give to God a good offering. Don't slap your God. If you believe, then the scripture says, it says, you give when you worship. Giving is a part of our worship. Come on, somebody. We started this off with 50. Obey the ushers. Get your gift in your hand and bring them on to the Lord. If you got a card, sister, take the payment over there. Lord, we're going to thank you, Jesus. Come on and bring your gift to the Lord. I want everything God got for me. Is there anybody want to come testify what the Lord has done for you this week? Amen. In these 3-day revival. Even if you got something tonight and you know that God spoke to your heart and you want to seal it, because the Bible said we overcome him by the blood of the Lamb and the words of our testimony. I want to give you an opportunity to come right now for 1 minute and share a testimony. If you don't, we're going to move on. Amen. You want to come on? Okay, come on, Sister Connie, come on. We got Brother Brooks too. All right, Brooks, you come. Come on, Brother Brooks. Brother Brooks said, "I want to testify." Glory to God. Amen. Come on, God. Come on. Yes, God.
How many know God is good? Anybody in the house know God is good? You know, I was just listening to Pastor preaching, and I was thinking to myself, if I had anything to say. Because, well, I know out of all of my faults, my God still loves me.
Amen. Woo! Come on, brother.
And I just wondered if I could just sing just a little something.
Now, come on, sing a little bit of blue.
Musician, can you give me some of that? Dum, 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 dum.
Yeah.
You can bear me
God tonight.
For the work that he's doing in me, and that he's going to complete in me, that he started, I turned back, and when I turned back, I could hear the Lord saying, even if you get high, even if you smoke, you're not going to get high. You know, the Holy Spirit is so, so important. Because without him, your flesh don't have a chance. It can't even breathe.
Come on now.
It can't even move. You can't even see without the Spirit. You can't walk, talk, move, nothing. So when he blew into me, it gave me back life. I just want to say, keep giving praise unto him and keep worshiping him and keep me lifted. Because I'm really going through.
God bless you. Come on. The best is yet to come. Come on here. Amen. Thank God the best is yet to come. My God, my God. Somebody say praise the Lord. Somebody say praise the Lord again. Amen. Everybody standing, we get ready to go home.